Tear you apart. Scared? Just like a
boy. Ooh. Fresh meat! Kick ass!
Ooh. Come on, boys! Fresh meat!
Come on, come on!
Yeah! Oh my God, I don't want to die! Thank you. shit. Come out and fight. I don't fight. Oh, this is gonna be fun. Time to take. Oh, shit! Oh! Dead. Dead! Just like a little bitch. Okay, cut the shit. Who is that? Thank you.
What's a desk, hell if I know, but I'm gonna keep talking anyway.
We interrupt our regularly scheduled program for
some news. Today's weather, excessively violent, with a chance of dismemberment. Tune in later for our 5-day forecast. Thanks for listening, children. This is Free Dog.
When you listen now, what a time for the inspirational words. From the mouth of your president.
Who the hell are you? Where'd you come from? Did Moriarty send you? That lying bastard. Roped you into finding me too, huh? Well, you're not getting a damn thing from me. You hear me? Not a damn thing.
What's the matter, huh? You can't stand the sight of your own flesh?
Our great democracy. So, as your president, I am the voice and the heart and soul of the enclave. That is to say, I am the voice, heart and soul of the enclave. Together, and we hope to reach our full potential. We were before the war, whole, one enclave, one America, now and
visit, partner.
Another newcomer.
Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, boy. Something tells me you're all right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something. Friendly and well-mannered. I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like. I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with? It's called the Wasteland for a reason, but there are settlements too spread all around. The human race is stubborn like that. To the south you've got Rivet City, but don't bother going to DC. The place is a war zone. Nope, sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town. Sure thing, partner. What do you need to find? Sure is. Moriarty's. The entrance is on the top level, opposite the main gate. Just be careful. Moriarty is not your friend, no matter what he may say. So don't fall for his lies. And for God's sake, don't trust the man. What about it? I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? You think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good? Oh, all right. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you.
Thunder of his voice. Let the men, women, and children of the earth come forth to gather and behold the power of Adam. Let those who dwell here in his favored land attend now. Has occurred in the past, and the resplendence of the promise of our future.
Evening. I don't recognize you. New in town or something? I hope by something to do you mean a job. Otherwise you want to talk with Nova. I'm looking for someone to make a delivery. Interested? Great. I'd like you to deliver this message to my family in the Arafu settlement. I haven't heard from them in months, and I'm worried. As soon as you get there, talk to Davis West. He'll be glad to pay you for the trip.
Deus the Saint, Dave.
I told you, Gob, it ain't the radio. The Enclave Station comes in fine. It's Galaxy News. Their signal's been shitlit.
My, my. Just when I had all but given up hope. My dear boy. I'm very happy to make your acquaintance. I am Mr. Burke. And you, well, you are not a resident of this putrescent cesspool. And makes you a rather valuable individual. As you wish. I'm looking to employ an individual with no ties to Megaton, no interest in its future. Megaton is obsolete, the last vestige of a cobbled, desperate past. It needs to go away, and you are going to see that it does. No. I'm merely a recruiter. You get to have the real fun. The undetonated atomic bomb for which this town is named is still very much alive. All it needs is a little motivation. I have in my possession A fusion pulse charge. Once rigged to the bomb, it will be detonated by you at a secure location. Easy money, my friend. Now that is a disappointment. Well, if you change your mind, the offer still stands. Good day.
Goddamn radio.
Hey,
you just leave that fucking thing alone, Gob.
Don't look at me like that. You want something?
Come on.
Gob. I'm not going to...
Hey, Smoothskin. You need something? A drink, maybe? Anything? Anything at all? Wait, you're not gonna hit me? Yell at me? Not even berate me a little bit? Well now, that's a surprise. I'm used to every asshole smooth skin in this town giving me shit just because I look like a corpse. I'm glad to see that there are a few worthwhile people around here. Listen, Moriarty'd have my head if he caught me selling at a discount. But for you, I'll risk it. Honestly, I usually keep my head down. I tend to get smacked around if I look customers in the eyes. But talk to Moriarty, he'll know more. Alright, I'll tell you. Please, just don't hurt me. Moriarty keeps the computer terminal in the back. On it, he keeps all of the dirty secrets of Megaton. If you can get onto that terminal, I'll bet he has information on your dad. Now, get away from me, Smoothskin. If Moriarty even suspects I told you this, I'm a dead ghoul.
Dead in the fire.
Hey, Pearl. I couldn't tell you, really. I'd talk to Manya if you care that much. She's lived in Megaton longer than anyone. Mr. Moriarty says we can keep it on. It's a good radio station. I like hearing the DJ, Three Dog, and how he's helping to fight the good fight. If only I was a part of that, instead of being stuck in this dive.
Colin Moriarty, at your service. Welcome to Moriarty's. My saloon, my home, my slice of heaven in this backwoods little burg. If you've got the caps, I've got your pleasure. Please sit down, make yourself comfortable. Your troubles are a thing of the past. Stay the fuck out of me business, don't go where you don't belong, and buy your drinks here. That's all you need to know. Galaxy News Radio is some loudmouth radio station located in the ruins of DC. Three Dog, the king of that loony bin, keeps yapping about fighting some good fight or something. A bunch of crap. But I suppose if you wanted to know what was going on in the wasteland, that's the place to go. Me, I could care less. The wasteland? Why the hell would you want to go out there? Listen to me, lad. Megaton has everything you could possibly need. Why go anywhere else?
What is it?
Small ambition, a worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire.
I hear you're that stray from the vault. Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you? Great! Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life, or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy. Oh, certainly, Your Majesty. Then consider this armored vault suit to be Megaton's gift to your mighty empire. However, you may consider going incognito. People around here don't always take kindly to monarchy, you know. That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun. Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words. Good enthusiasm! Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first? Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right? So they need a good place to find them. There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it. Oh, great! Food is most important, but see if you can get medicine, too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay? See? So, how's this... Good hunting!
If you do need to head into the heat, be smart. Give yourself a nice boost of Rad X first. Remember, only you can prevent human flesh fires. And now, some music.
Hey, everybody, did the news get around about a guy named Winter Pete? Old Pete just flew into this town and he's chomping up all the women's meat.
He's hacking and whacking and smacking. He's hacking and whacking and smacking.
Hey there.
Song herself, Miss Ella Fitzgerald, telling us that into each life some rain must fall. Ain't that the truth, sister?
The hell with it! Stop moving around!
Into each life some rain. Someday the sun will shine. Some folks can lose the blues in their hearts, but when I think of you, another shower starts. Into each life some rain must fall. But too much is falling in mine.
Into each life some rain must fall. But too much is falling in mine.
Can I interest you in an extremely rare refreshment? It's called a Nuka-Cola Quantum. It's much better than your average Nuka-Cola. It even glows in the dark. Only 100 caps, my friend, and a bargain at twice the price. Why, I know a lady in Gertershade who'd pay through the nose for one. Well, it'll save me the trip. Fine, you've got a deal. Enjoy. Everything. Thanks.
Some tears gotta fall. I know that someday that sun is bound to shine.
Some folks can lose the blues in their heart, but when I think of you, another shower starts into each life. Some rain must fall, but too much is falling.
Kentucky. I had the best friend a boy could hope for.
Monsters, they're gonna get me. Those things, they keep coming. They scare me. Make it stop. You look stronger than all the other grown-ups. Can you protect me? Those big things, they're all over Graditch, and they killed everyone. Please, mister, please find my papa. You will? Really? Thanks a whole lot. My house is the one closest to the huge sign and the old diner. Please, find my papa and make him come back. Nope. Come on, tell me.
What's up, Wastelanders? This is Freedog, Bow Wow, and you're listening to GNR. That's Galaxy News Radio, in case you forgot. Let me ask you something, children. You hungry for some 200-year-old Salisbury steak? You hungry for some news? I'm guessing news. I've been getting more and more reports of these mercenary maniacs from Talon Company, especially in the downtown DC area. If you see these hombres, steer clear. Whatever you have, they want, and they're not really into asking politely. Word is, these guys take all the contracts the other mercs won't. In short, there's nothing they won't do. So be careful out there. Until next time, this is Three Dog!
Ow!
And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio, bringing you the truth, no matter how bad it hurts. Now,
you
wish on the moon and look for the gold in a rainbow, and you'll find happy thoughts. You'll hear a tune that lives in the heart of a bluebird, and you'll find happy thoughts. Though things may look very dark, your dream is not in vain.
Already.
He's dead? I guess I already knew. Besides, I'm too tired to cry anymore.
You gotta stop it, so this can't happen to anyone else's family ever again. I wish I had met you a long time ago, and then maybe my dad would still be alive. Thanks for doing all this. I'm feeling better now that you're here.
Maybe tomorrow you will suddenly hear chimes, and you'll have your happy, happy
set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. That one is you, no other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love, and with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your
I don't want to set the world on fire.
Incoming!
I love you.
Bring it!
I just want to
no!
Flame down in your heart. Way down inside of me. Darling, I have only one desire. That one desire is you, and I know nobody else ain't gonna do it.
You don't wanna be my new boyfriend.
I
is one and three's the one you love. And with your admission,
everybody, this is Three Dog, your friendly neighborhood disc jockey. What's a disc? Hell if I know, but I'm gonna keep talking anyway. Here's the latest news. Unemployment is down, stocks are up, and the UN has just declared global peace forever. Now the real news. Not too long ago, I reported that a cat recently left Vault 101. His name is James. Good guy. Turns out, it gets better. I've got a new report here that says someone else has just climbed out of that hole. What the hell is going on down there? Revolution? Vacation? Somebody fart? Your guess is as good as mine, kids. Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog. Ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. And now, some music. This is the Ink Spots with their timeless classic, Model 107 on Fire. You're listening to Galaxy News Radio, and I'm your host, Three Dog, Lord and Master of all. And here's me! Those of you not in the know, to the northwest of Megaton is this vault, Vault 101. Now, believe it or not, this one's still got people living in it. And every few years or so, someone comes scrabbling out. Well, wouldn't you know it, someone's come out of it again. And, I kid you not, he came to visit yours truly right here in the studio. Now, this this cat. James is his name. They've been in a long years. He needed to know what was put out here in the beautiful Capital Wasteland. So I, the great and powerful Freedom, sent my brothers to meet. I told them what was what. Well, the winners, the losers, the movers. So if you see James out there, you say hello. Be kind to our new brother. Outside, we always fight this good fight. Hey, and in case a light bulb just started glowing over your head, you can flip the switch and get it. You're not getting into that vault. Whoever lives in there sure as hell doesn't want what you're selling. And no, you can't knock down the door. It weighs like 13 tons. Thanks for listening, children. This is Three Dog. Ow! And you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. And now a super important public service announcement. Just a friendly reminder to all you would-be bigots out there. Ghouls are people, too. You see, children, ghouls are simply humans who've been exposed to an ungodly amount of radiation and haven't had the good fortune to die. Sure, they may look like hideous zombies from an old monster flick, but their hearts, their souls, their tears are all very much human. So please, if you meet one of the Capital Wasteland's mini ghouls, leave your prejudice at the door and your pistol in its holster. Ah, yes, one important caveat, kiddies. Those feral ghouls that prefer the dark, dank underground, they are basically mindless zombies. So kill as many as you damn well please. And now, some music.
You know, I think I've found a new way to prepare rad roach meat. Still tastes like old feet, though.
Anyway, what's up with you?
So, how's the scavenging been? Got the food and medicine from that super duper mart? Really? You did? You did! Well, all right! Tell me all about it. So you're saying that they acquired a well-protected stash? I wonder how many other places are hiding treasures behind monsters. Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit, my treat. Tastes kind of great after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better. I still need to study a living specimen with radiation poisoning. I need someone to research how to travel through a minefield. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy? Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? I know lots about it from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning, so I can study its effects. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that. Oh, you're a peach! Or at least some sort of hardy fruit that grows in the savagely irradiated mockery of agriculture we have nowadays. Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness. But if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of.
And behold the power of Adam. Let those who dwell here in his favorite land attend now to the words of the prophet of Adam. Come forth and drink the waters of the globe, for this ancient weapon of war is our salvation. It is the very symbol of Adam's glory. Let it serve as a reminder of the division that has occurred in the past. and the resplendence of the promise of our divisions in the times to come. Give your bodies to Adam, my friend. Release yourself to his power. Feel his glow and be divine. There shall be no tears, no sorrows, no suffering. For in the division, we shall see our way.
Oh, feeling a bit under the weather, or a bit over the Geiger counter. I can tell you're positively glowing. Now, just hold on and try not to move. Tell me how it feels, and I'll get you fixed right up. You're a mighty lucky one, you know that? At this state, most people have trouble standing up, much less walking over here. Now, let me take a few notes, and I'll handle that nasty radiation with a bit of my own homemade rad cure concoction. I've never had a chance to test it out on someone so heavily dosed, but I'm sure it'll work out fine. Exciting, isn't it? Okay, a little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy thoughts. Well, you're alive! Oh, that's the good news. But there was a little side effect. A teeny tiny, mutation. But it seems to be benign, at least. Here, take a few radiation chems, as my little way of saying, I'm sorry I twisted your DNA like a kitten with a ball of yarn. Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Minefield. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring back a mine for my studies? Oh, don't worry. No one ever goes there because they say it's a ghost town. And since ghosts don't exist, you can just focus on the landmines. I hear there's a playground in the middle of town. Reach that point and come back, and I'm sure you'll have some stories to tell.
God bless you.
The USA and nowhere else. Yeah, you need something?
You're looking good.
We both know the answer, don't we? None. America's children live in a terrifying, meaningless existence. There is no hope, no happiness. That changes right here, right now. From this moment onward, the children of this great nation are its highest priority. The Enclave will restore every American school, reinstate every youth program, and offer counseling and financial assistance to any family in need. We will match up the destitute, orphaned children of the Capital Wasteland with qualified, eligible adults. We will rebuild the American family as it was meant to be. Values of our past shall be the foundation of our future. So remember, America. The Enclave is working around the clock to return this country to greatness. All you need is a little patience, a little faith. Till next time, this is your president, John Henry Eden, signing off. John Henry Eden, and you're listening to Enclave Radio. Voice of warmth and reason in this cold, unreasonable world. This is President Eden, and you're listening to Enclave Radio, the voice of America. Hello, my beautiful America. This is President Eden, and it's time we had a talk. We live in an age of poverty, greed, violence, destruction. Indeed, the very seat of the federal government, Washington, D.C., has been reduced to what is now known as the Capital Wasteland. The Capital Wasteland. How did it come to this, America? How did your leaders allow the most powerful nation on Earth to die? The answer is really quite simple. Incompetence. Incompetence at the highest echelons of power. We put our trust, our faith in...
How are those hot little potatoes? Because, you know, they're on the ground. Like potatoes, and hot because they, explode. Anyway, what's up? My very own landmine! Oh, just what I've always wanted. Well, always since I sent you out on this, anyway. Now, tell me all about it. What was it like going through there? What's it like disarming a landmine? Lots of places are nowadays. Good work staying alive in tough conditions. It'll be a great example for the book. I know you may not want to see any more explosives for a while, but obviously you know your way around them. Have a couple rainy day toys of mine. And looking at this landmine gives me an idea. It's a terrible device that does terrible things, of course. But it's easy to make your own, too. Yep, you've done a great job. I just need to add in the section on how to cook rat, and this chapter's done. Here, for your services, I've saved up quite a few stim packs. Of course, you may need them. We still've got two more chapters to go. Well, I can't force you to work, I suppose.
Radio with your host, me, President John Henry.
Good hunting.